Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you DHCP protocol, that is Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. Here with the use of DHCP protocol, what we do is we provide configured IP to host. So whenever any host is interested to communicate in computer network, at that time, that host will be assigned with configured IP using this protocol. So to understand this protocol, let me tell you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first I'll explain you how many basics are there with this protocol. After that, I'll explain you how working is there with this protocol. And after working, I'll explain you one practical example in my computer. And in that, I'll explain you how this protocol is functioning with the use of Wireshark software. So in Wireshark software, I'll show you how DHCP request is forwarded, how DHCP acknowledgement comes, and how many datas that is there inside that, everything that we will be discussing in great detail, right? So let us see first how many basics are there with DHCP protocol. So in basics of DHCP protocol, you should know it is dynamic host configuration protocol, where we use this protocol to automate the process of assigning IP address. Like in any LAN, as if any host is interested for communication, then that host should be assigned by IP address. Like for example, if at your home you want to access Wi-Fi, then you will be turning on your Wi-Fi, and as and when you turn on your Wi-Fi, at that time you will be asking for IP configuration first, and that will be done with the usage of this protocol, right? And right now in 2023, practically everyone is using this protocol only for IP assignment, right? See, this DHCP protocol that also supports relaying concept, as we have seen it in BOOTP protocol. In BOOTP protocol, what we have seen in that, I have explained you, there will be relay agent, and because of that you don't need to have BOOTP server with every subnetwork. So here with this DHCP protocol, it also supports this relaying concept, as we have seen it in BOOTP protocol. So I'm not going to explain you that concept again. You just see my previous video based on BOOTP protocol. In that, I have explained that by practical example, right? Here, DHCP protocol that does IP assignment as per static and dynamic table entries. So in working, I'll show you how exactly it will assign IP as per static and dynamic entries, right? So that is very essential and you need to know this. So that I'll explain you by practical example in working. See, DHCP protocol that will provide static IP assignment for always on type of host. See, static IP assignment means what? That IP assignment will be having fixed IP address to particular host. And fixed IP assignment that will be given to always on host. Like servers are there, those servers will be always on. So for them, there has to have static IP assignment. But as if we talk about dynamic IP assignment, so that will be given to temporary host. For example, in your home, if you turn on your Wi-Fi, then you will be temporary host, right? It is not like continuously you will be using Wi-Fi for entire year, right? So for that, you will be given with temporary IP assignment as per dynamic IP assignment. Now let us try to understand that by working, so that will give you more clarity. So in working of DHCP protocol, we need to understand how IP assignment happens, right? So as I have told you, there can be two types of entries. One is static and second is dynamic. So how DHCP protocol will define it? Let us try to understand that. So let me give you one practical example. Let us say here we are having one host, and this host comes into the network of router 1, and let us say this router is Wi-Fi router, and here this host is turning on its Wi-Fi router, and at that time, first of all, this host should be assigned with IP, otherwise this host cannot communicate in this entire computer network, right? So what this host will do is, it will be asking for DHCP request. It will be asking for DHCP request over here, right? So DHCP request that this host will be asking, right? And this frame that is getting broadcasted in this entire network first. Why it is getting broadcasted? The reason is this host is not having an idea about which host is having DHCP server. For example, when one node is entering to the network, at that time DHCP request is forwarded, but that host is not having an idea about which host is DHCP server right now. That DHCP server may be over here, it may be over here, it may be the router. Practically, let me tell you, DHCP server that is implemented on the router only, right? But in general, this host is not having an idea about which host is DHCP server, so it will be broadcasting this request. And those requests will go to all the hosts in this network, and DHCP server that will recognize, okay, somebody is asking for IP configuration. So what this DHCP server will do? This DHCP server that will give DHCP acknowledgement, and in that acknowledgement there will be IP address. In that acknowledgement there will be IP address, and that will be unicast to this host, right? That will be unicast to this host. I'll show you how many datas are there in this practically, but right now first of all you need to understand what is happening. See, the host who is newly coming in the network will be asking for IP address first. So first of all, DHCP request will be broadcasted in this network. The reason is this host is not having idea about which host is having DHCP server. Practically, let me tell you, this router will be having DHCP server. Nowadays, majority of routers are so intelligent, which is having DHCP server integrated in it, right? So here, after that, DHCP server will give acknowledgement in which there will be IP, and that IP will be assigned to this host. And now this host can use that configured IP for communication in the entire computer network. See, that is how it is happening. But here, there are two types of IP assignment. You see, one is static and second is dynamic. So there will be, obviously, with DHCP server, there will be entries, right? So with respect to MAC address, there will be IP addresses. And those IP assignment, that could be static or dynamic. See, with static IP assignment, there will be no least time. Least time means, static means always on. So with always on, there will be no least time, means those IPs are permanently given to particular host, right? And that we will be giving it to servers in majority of cases, right? But when it comes to dynamic IP assignment, then in that there will be least time. So see, maximum least time for dynamic IP assignment, that will be 90 days, right? So obviously, host will be asking for IP, and DHCP server will be giving IP to that. And when DHCP server gives IP to particular host, at that time it will give two things. One is least time, and second is renewal time. So it will say like, okay, for this many days you can use this IP. For this many days you can use this IP, as well as it will say you will have to renew it after some time even. You can use it for these many days, but also you will have to do renewal operation, right? That is how things are there in dynamic IP assignment using DHCP server. So now what I'll do is I'll explain you that by practical example. So let me take you to my computer on Wireshark software. So if you observe this Wireshark software, then in that what happened, you know, like I have turned on my computer. At that time, I was requesting for IP address, right? So you see, source was not having IP address initially. So that was 0000, right? Means source is not having IP address over here, right? Now, if you observe destination, so that is 255.255.255.255. What it means? This is broadcast frame. This is broadcast frame in given local area network. So you can say like, I have broadcasted one frame over here, that is DHCP request. You can observe here, it is written DHCP request, right? So in DHCP request, source is having 0000 IP, means source is not having IP. Source will be giving what? Source will be giving information regarding its own MAC address, and it will be broadcasting over here. So in my local area network, I have broadcasted one frame, that is DHCP request over here. Now in response to this, my router, that is this, and this is my destination, this is my IP. So this IP is assigned by router to me, right? So now you can observe, see my router is forwarding frame to me, and in that frame it will be assigning IP, right? So now my IP is this, and that is assigned as per DHCP protocol, right? Now let me show you a few essential information over here. See, I have filtered this frame over here. The reason is there were so many frames, so it was a bit difficult for me to identify how DHCP frames are there. So I have filtered it over here. Otherwise you would have seen so many other frames also, like TCP frames, UDP frames, right? So let me show you first what are the information which is there in this frame. So I have clicked on it, right? And now if you observe here, see how many things are there. So here we are having this broadcast destination address and source address IP, that is 0, right? So it is getting broadcasted over here, and in my LAN all the host will receive this frame, that is based on DHCP request. So what I want is, I just wanted to have IP address, right? Now my router is giving me a DHCP acknowledgement. Now let me click on it. So how many information is there, let me show you. So if you observe here, we are having DHCP acknowledgement in which my router have assigned IP to me, right? So this is my router and this is my IP now. So this IP, that is assigned to me. So you can observe here, see, sender source address, that is this, that is my router's address, and destination address, that is my IP address. Now my IP is assigned as per this, and I can communicate in computer network now, right? But if you observe, as I have told you, I am right now, which category of user? I am right now temporary user, or you can say there should be dynamic IP with me, right? So in dynamic IP, if you observe here how many informations are there, you see here leash time that is given to me. And how much leash time that is given to me? One day means 86400 seconds. So leash time that is given to me, and that leash time is how much? One day, right? So for one day I can use this IP right now, right? See, that is how IP assignment that has been done. And if you observe here, a few more informations are there, like how much option field is there. This is IPv4, right? So there will be option field, there will be domain name, server. See, all those things that we will study in next coming videos. So these are the information that is provided to me. So now I think you are having fair enough idea like how exactly this protocol is functioning, right? So let me take you to my computer screen again. So here, my dear students, all you need to understand is, first of all, whenever you want to access internet, you should be having IP, and that IP assignment that will happen with DHCP protocol. So there can be two types of IP assignment. One is static, second is dynamic. Dynamic IP assignment will be having leash time. That explains, for that much time, this IP is assigned to you, right? So in that DHCP request frame, in DHCP request frame given by DHCP server, that IP and that leash time, all the information will be given to you, right? And DHCP request forwarded by host will be broadcasted in this entire network, that you should know. And if still anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.